does Netflix decide what content it should bet on and spend billions of dollars on a year? How does American Express use social media data to prevent churn of their customers? And how does Starbucks use data to get customers to be more loyal? Underlying all these questions is the use of data. Hi, I'm Chris Ittner, a professor at the Wharton School, and I'm excited to bring you this business analytics course that I have created along with seven of my faculty colleagues at Wharton. In today's data-rich business environment, companies that don't take a sophisticated approach to measuring and analyzing key data about their customers, their operations, their people, and their accounts risk being left behind. In this course, we introduce you to a wide spectrum of analytic techniques and show you how to apply them across your business. We've designed this course to enable you to gain insights into how businesses use data to optimize marketing, revenue, operations, hiring, and management practices to make their own data-driven business decisions. The Wharton School has been at the forefront of research and analytics going back 100 years, way before the advent of big data. This course draws on a diverse array of faculty, each teaching in their own areas of specialization. In addition to videos and application exercises with data sets, you will also have an opportunity to hear from and interact with faculty in live webinars. Let me tell you a little bit about what you will learn in the course. You'll get an introduction to analytics for all business professionals, including those with no prior experience, and will help you develop an analytics mindset to make strategic decisions based on data. We begin with descriptive analytics, which is just as it sounds, what data can and cannot describe. How is data used to explore a problem, and how would you use that data to create products or marketing campaigns? We will also see how descriptive analytics is used in a fundamental operations problem of matching supply with demand. For example, how does Time Incorporate optimize supply of their print issues so retailers have enough issues to meet demand? We'll then move into looking at how we can make predictions about the future using data. We call this predictive analytics. We'll focus on regression and probability models to understand how to make predictions about the future. You will learn the advantages and limitations of both approaches and be able to determine which framework is more useful for a given situation. For example, how can a nonprofit organization, such as a university, learn from past giving patterns of their alumni to make predictions about future donations? And finally, we'll look at prescriptive analytics, which focuses on recommendations for actions you can take to achieve your business goals. You'll learn how optimization, simulations, and decision trees can be used together to solve complex business problems with high degrees of uncertainty. For example, how can a furniture retailer decide how many pieces to manufacture and which supplier to use given uncertain demand in the future? During this course, you'll have the opportunity to apply these concepts to real-world business problems through case studies. You'll learn the advantages and limitations of the various techniques and learn how to ask the right questions about a data set and an analysis. At the end of the course, you'll use a computer simulation to make decisions about the manufacturing and marketing of a consumer goods product. I'm so excited to invite you to join us on this journey through analytics and how they can be used to improve your business. The world is moving quickly. It's getting more complex and some might say chaotic every day. A good grasp of analytics can help you make sense of the vast array of information you have or can have at your fingertips. Don't be left behind. I look forward to seeing you in the class.